everyone, welcome to Vishwabloom. So today we'll be looking at polynomials class 8 AM5 emerald package. First question. So the question says, actually, the number of values of a for which a square minus 3a plus 2ax into x square plus a square minus 5a plus 6 into x plus a square minus 4 is equal to 0 is identity of x. Is so we have to find value of a. So such a long question, don't think that it's we'll do step by step, bit by bit. First, into x, you whatever it is there into x, just take it out first. Now we will write a square minus 3a plus 2. Here into x square is there, but I'm not writing it because it's the identity in is equal to x. Now, what when you factorize it, we are going to get it as a minus 1 into a minus 2 is equal to 0. Then a values are going to be 1 and 2. Right, then we will see the next part bit by bit. I said no. Or a square minus 5a plus 6. For this x is multiplied, right? So that also I didn't write because it's identity, I told you, equal to 0. Then it is the factors are going to be a minus 3 into a minus 2 equal to 0. Then when you equate them separately, we will be getting as 2 comma 3. Next is a square minus 4. Right? This one is directly 0. There's no x here. Okay, then what is going to be the factor? A minus 2 into a plus 2 equal to 0. Then this will be 2, this will be minus 2. So the common, what you found the common value? It is 2, right? 2, 2 and 2. So plus 2 is the common value. The common value of a is going to be a is equal to. Fine, now let's look at the second question. Now second question, we have x square minus px plus q is equal to 0. For that, alpha and beta are the roots. So we have to find alpha power minus 3 plus beta power minus 3 divided by alpha cube plus beta cube. Okay, this is the question. Now first, every time what we will do? Alpha plus beta we will find, right? It is minus b by a and it is minus of minus q divided by 1. So it is p. Okay, then alpha beta. So alpha beta is c by a, q by 1 and it's q. Okay. Next, what we have to do? We have to do with this form. Alpha power minus 3 plus beta power minus 3 divided by alpha plus beta cube. That will be equal to 1 by alpha cube plus 1 by beta cube. And why it is like that means minus will represent that it is reciprocal. Sorry, 1 by. Okay. Then divided by alpha plus. Alpha cube plus beta cube. Then that will be is equal to. What will happen is this. Same we are writing only, but some differences will be getting once again. Sorry, I confused you. Nothing to worry, we were just finding the LCM, okay? I got confused in that step. We have to find LCM. Beta cube plus alpha cube divided by alpha cube by beta cube. Then again divided by alpha cube, b
beta cube, beta cube by 1. Fine, so there's not no changes itself. Sorry, this plus, right? Forgot that plus. Then what you will do, now this one we will just bring it to the side, that multiplication we will do. That only division, like fractions we do know, that kind we will do. So beta cube plus alpha cube divided by alpha cube into beta cube, that is equal to, sorry, we have into 1 by alpha cube b plus beta cube. Like how we will do for fractions, only same way. Now, alpha beta cube plus alpha cube plus beta cube, both are same only, right? Cancel them. Then we are left with 1 by alpha cube beta cube. Okay, now what is alpha into alpha beta cube? In the sense, it is 1 by alpha beta cube, right? So what is alpha beta? It is q. Now you will write 1 by q cube. So how we can write this? Q inverse, right? Q inverse power 3. Option is option C. Okay, C option. Then let's look at the third one. The third question. So the roots of ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. The roots are equal only, but we have to find the roots. Okay, let's do first. Let alpha plus beta is equal to b minus b by a. And if alpha is equal to beta, that is only the case here, roots are equal in the sense, okay. So what will happen that time, you will not write like this. You will write alpha plus alpha or beta plus beta. Any one, okay, is equal to minus b by a. That will be 2 alpha, so I can just write there only, right? 2 alpha is equal to minus b by a. Then alpha, what is the value of alpha? Alpha is equal to minus b by 2a. Then beta is also minus b by 2a. So alpha also minus b by 2a. Okay, that is option C. Now let's look at the fourth question. For A is less than 0, B is less than 0, C is less than 0, both roots of equation AX square plus BX plus C is equal to 0 are real and obviously negative. Because A, B, C are itself negative. Because they are less than 0 means like a negative only. That's why. Option A. Now let's look at the fifth one. So this fifth question is a little bit different only. The first equation is given AX square plus BX plus C is equal to 0. Right, so 16AC we have to find. And also they have given one root is 3 times other. So it is alpha 3 alpha. Then sum of roots first, that is alpha plus beta we will do, right? It is sum of roots. So that will be alpha plus 3 alpha, which is 4 alpha is equal to minus b by a. Then alpha is equal to minus b by 4a. Then alpha, when we square on both sides, it will become alpha square is equal to minus b square by 16a square. Then you can just cancel this alpha square. So what we will do is we will just multiply. So this, that much only, this is done. Now product of roots, that means alpha into 3 alpha is equal to c by a. then what will happen? Or 3 alpha square, this one, is equal to C by A. Then alpha square is C by 3A. Then what we will do, we will alpha square, what is the value? Here we have already got, right? That one we will substitute here. Minus B square divided by 16A square is equal to C by 3A. Now cancel everything, whatever is there, then cross multiply. So this one can be cancelled here. So here I am continuing. 16AC is equal to 3B square. And what, that is what we wanted. Answer is 3B square, option B. Next we will see the 6th question. Now we will see the 6th problem. The 6th question is alpha and beta are the roots for the expansion. So which expansion? I don't know. I will write on the board. X minus A into X minus B. So for that expansion, it is, okay, that will be equal to C. And C is not equal to, sorry, A is not equal to 0. Now, what we have to find actually there, the roots of equation of alpha minus, sorry, X minus alpha into X minus beta plus C is equal to 0. So that one we have to find. So now, first we will just write it in such a way. Sorry, we'll multiply them. So X square minus BX, like this. Okay, then minus AX minus, sorry, plus AB minus C. So how did I get all this? Just again, this also I multiply and equal to C, sorry, not minus C. Huh, sorry. This C will bring it to LHS, it become minus C. There will be 0 over there. Then what we will do, we will just take common here. X square normally only we will take. Then X is common only right here. So we will take that as A plus B whole into X plus AB minus C is equal to 0. Then first we will find alpha plus beta, that is A plus B, and alpha into beta is AB minus C. Fine, then now we have to solve this alpha minus, sorry, X minus alpha into X minus beta minus, sorry, plus C is equal to 0. Now substituting all that, okay, alpha minus beta, sorry, X value first we will substitute, X square minus beta, beta X plus alpha X, sorry, we are not substituting anything, multiplying like this, this is not alpha X, okay, we are multiplying it first, okay, minus alpha X plus alpha beta plus C is equal to 0, then now taking common here, X will take common, X square minus X into beta minus, sorry, alpha plus beta, because minus into minus is plus, right? Alpha plus beta, then plus alpha beta plus C is equal to 0. Then you can now see, just I'll put here this one once again, just writing that equation, okay, this one, A plus X into A plus B plus AB plus C is equal to, sorry, minus C is equal to 0. So we will put one more plus C over there. You can add, right? Yes. Then what will happen? That C term will go over. Go. Then we will get X square minus A plus B into X plus AB is equal to 0. Okay, then the roots are A comma B. Option C.
Okay, next we'll see the next one. Now we'll see the 7th question, 8th question, 9th question and 10th question matrix matching. In ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, a is not equal to 0 and discriminant is equal to b square minus 4ac is called discriminant. Sorry, the delta is equal to. If the roots are equal, then what will happen? They are asking, if a delta will be equal to 0, then if roots having opposite signs, then what will happen? They are asking, c by a will be greater than 0. Ninth question, if both the roots are negative, then what will happen? B minus b by a will be greater than 0. Then 10th one, if both the roots are positive, then what will happen? D will happen, that is minus b by a will be less than 0. Do like, share and subscribe to Vishwa Blooms. Thanks for watching. Bye. Next we'll see diamond package. Okay, bye.